You know what I like most about YouTube? That you can kind of look like this, but wear pants like this. Smoking. Feeling spicy and smoking and feeling spicy. Never mind. Well, hello my lovely nestlings and welcome to my channel. If you are new, welcome. My name is Nikki. I'm 44 from the Netherlands, hence the accent, and I love to play with makeup. Mainly drugstore and indie. As long as it's cruelty-free, then I am happy. If you like that too, and like colorful makeup, but also neutral makeup, a little bit of weirdness, sarcasm, and all that, then then don't forget to subscribe, because I upload a lot. In today's video, I am going to review for you the new Makeup Obsession palettes. I have them both here, the Smoking and the Feeling Spicy. And this is the look that I did with the Smoking palette. The timestamps for both palettes will be down in the description box. And I'm going to start by telling you a little bit about the palette. Then I will show you the look that I created. And after the look, I will give you my thoughts. And then that's going to be basically it. So yeah, let's start. Oh yeah, grab a drink, grab a snack, put your feet up. Because I also tend to ramble. Just to be on the safe side, so you are at least, you know, taken care of before we really get into it. But I'm going to start with the Smoking palette. It has 9 shades. I love the way that it looks. It looks sleek. It's also a smaller palette. And it has 1 true matte. And the rest are, yes, satiny shades. The shade Velvet, that's the one with the black with the purpley sparkles in it, is a little bit of a weird shade because it kind of looks like a matte, but it feels very, very sticky and almost feels like a shimmer. So it's a very interesting shade. Yeah, you get, what is it? The pens weigh 0.10 ounces or 0.38 grams each. Wow, that is very difficult to talk, but yeah, it is basically one of their micro palettes. That is it. So, without kind of further ado, let me show you how I created this look. And after that, I will tell you, well, my experiences with the palette and how it performed on the eyeballs. Yes. So, the lightest one is called Charcoal, that one. Which is not really a charcoal gray, because charcoal is darker. In my opinion, at least. But yeah, I haven't set the base. Let's see what it does. It blends out very, very nicely. Okay, let's go to a slightly smaller brush. Still the same color though. Because even though there are only 2 mattes in here, and then basically the one that I'm using now is maybe even more of a longer the lines of a satin anyway, it does not mean that you cannot play with depth. So let's see how they layer. Well, not too shabby, so let's blend it up a little bit. Back to the first brush, a tiny bit of that same color. Just to make sure that the top blend is nice. And I'm leaving a part open, but I usually do that because I know that I want to use the black anyway. So I don't need to blend this all the way down. What the hell is happening with my brows? Because I bleached my hair again, I thought let's kind of bleach the eyebrows then as well. It was not a good idea. Just saying. So now the pencil that I usually use is too light. So I'm using an eye pencil, which works, but yeah, also kind of not, you know? Sometimes you try something, sometimes you shouldn't, you know? Okay, so I can't see the sheen that this gray has, just saying, so if you don't like that, then yeah. Then you only have 1 true matte, you know? Okay, I'm going to go to that matte now, which is the black, and it's called Damn. Exciting, it's a black. I'm going in slow. Let's see. So basically I'm just following my eyeball. And then checking to see if the darkness is where I want it. It is. So now I can just lightly blend up a bit. Blends out very nicely. Okay, let's grab a smaller brush and a little bit of that black in the outer corner on the lower lash line. Now for shimmers, you can kind of go a number of ways. Let's start with the shade. I don't really know if it is a true shimmer, but let's start with that shade anyway. I'm grabbing the shade Velvet, which is a black with, I don't know if it is micro glitter or a shimmer, because it is very sticky when I swatch it. Oh yeah, I think it's a matte with micro glitter in it. But they do kind of show up, so. Fallout. I'm using it as a matte now, which was maybe not a good idea. I'm actually curious to see what will happen when I grab it on a brush like this. And let's spray for funsies, because I can. Let's see what happens. Can I pick it up on the brush? I can. Going to put it out the corner. I don't really know what kind of shade it is, but it is pretty. Not a lot of fallout, so that's good. So maybe it is kind of a shimmery shade. I have no idea. I also have the shade Midnight. Oh. And then the shade Sizzle. Let's put Midnight underneath the eye. So let's grab a pencil that kind of matches. Maybe a red pencil would have been very, very cool too. I'm just thinking about that now. But obviously I didn't. I'm going to go into the shade called Midnight, but it is not spelled like normal Midnight. It is spelled with a K, which is funny. I think it is at least. Oh no, it's not. Maybe I need a new prescription for my lenses, because lately I don't know what's happening. Very dramatic. I want the... What else do I have? Yeah, but that's too happy. Yeah, you know, I kind of want to try them all. So I'm first going to go to the shade Sultry, and then I'm going to probably put this shade on top, which is called Fine. So let's put it on top. Shade Sultry first. Which is a satin, but very pretty. Okay, let's go to the shade Fine then. Which is more of a metallic, yeah. I don't put shades. I want to use the shade Sizzle on the lid, so let's do that. I need glitter primer though. Where is it here? Just a small bit. And I'm going to follow my eyeball, literal eyeball, with the brush to get the shape that I want. And I'm kind of cleaning up the lid a little bit. Okay, yes. Then I'm going to go to the shade Sizzle, which is the center shade. Oh, very pretty. I am digging my brush in and creating a bit of fallout, but that's also because the pans are pretty tiny. So I'm really wiggling my brush in, because I have already swatched the palette and it is not really creating hard pan, but kind of creating hard pan. This is such a cool shade, by the way. Also going to bring it a little bit on top of that purple. This is a... It doesn't have a brown base when I look at it. It's more of a dark, very, very deep teal with a... almost a purple base? Purple shift? Yeah, teal to purple instead of teal to brown, which is very, very pretty. It does remind me of my favorite shade in the 50-50 Makeup Autumn palette, Decay, but it is not that though. It is different. Of course, fallout, okay. But it wipes away, so that's good. It's very, very, very pretty shade, and it goes very well with this shade as well. Not so much maybe with that one, but it is on there nonetheless. So let's grab that shade Velvet that I have in the outer corner. and just mix a little bit. And because this shade also has purple in it, it does go together. Nice. Grabbing a little bit of that velvet and put it in the crease. Shall I put the shade lid in the inner corner? Sure, why not? So with the same brush I just used for the shimmer, I don't know if you will see it. I am going to go into this shade. I don't know if you will see it, but we shall see. There's also more of a satin formula, looks like. Yeah, I don't like it. Not in combination with what I have on the lid. So I'm going to put the shimmer sizzle on top again. Yes, that's better. Okay, let's finish the eye look off with the shade Fine in the inner corner, which is that silver. Let's see if it is light enough. I'm going to spray it. I'm cleaning my brush because I picked up quite a lot. I'm just going to fade it over a bit everywhere. I don't particularly like the silver in the inner corner though. But I don't think there's a lot that I can do about it. Maybe I can put the shade Sizzle a little bit more on top of that silver. Yeah, something like that, I think. Let me just finish off the eyes, put on liner lashes and a lippy, and then I will be back and I will give you my thoughts on the palette. I've been talking for 10 minutes without recording, apparently. But yeah, so let's do it again then. Here is the completed look. Wow, nice and witchy vibes. Very, very pretty. I did swap out the eye pencil though, because I removed the eye pencil that I had used and I put in two purples, one from Essence and one from Kiko. Essence is in the shade Purple Rain and Kiko is in the shade 13. They will be linked down in the description box, or listed at least. The lippy I have on is from VE Cosmetics. It is a matte liquid lip in the shade Anarchy, which is a purple, but which is a gray, but has a tiny bit of a purple hint in it. Falses are from Primark. Let's go to the palette then. Am I recording? Yes, which is a good thing. Basically, you have one true matte in here, and that is the black. I personally don't mind it too much, because if I want to create a smoky eye and I want this kind of color story, this is basically enough for me. I do love to grab a browner shade to use as a transition base if I'm going to use a black to create a smoky eye. However, it does not really need it. The way that I used it today, by pulling in this one, which is a satin, but not as very, very shiny as some other satins can be, it works beautifully, and then everything blends on top of it very, very nicely. Oh yeah, what I did do here is I put a little bit of this shade with a fluffy brush just there to give it a little bit extra hint. If you want to create a matte smoky eye, you can do it beautifully. Start with this one, or start with a brown transition shade if you prefer that. But you can start with this one the way that I use it, then deepen it up with this, and then put this one on the lid, and then this one in the inner part, you know, and then maybe this one in the inner corner to create that nice gradient. That would be very, very lovely as well. What I did say, but that was not recorded, was that I would have loved to have a dark purple matte in here. Why? Because it will complement this one very, very nicely, and it will complement this one very nicely, and it would complement this one as well. Which one would I want to swap out though? I can see this one appealing to a lot of people because it is so nice and shiny and foiled. For me though, it is either inner corner or not. I would swap out this shade with a dark purple matte. Now, I know that a lot of people will love this shade. Me, not so much. I personally feel that if you have texture on your eyelids and you put a shade like this on top, it emphasizes it a little bit more. That's not to say that it cannot be pretty. It's just, for me, I don't like that look on my eyelids. This shade is very unique to my collection again. When I looked at it firstly, I thought it is another brown with a teal shift. It's actually not. It doesn't have a brown base. It has a almost a purple red base. When I shift it like this, I don't even know if you can see it, but when I shift it, it has a purple, more of a purple base, purple red base than a brown base. And that is why I say I would love to have a dark purple in here, because I think that would be gorgeous. This shade combined with a dark purple crease, and then deepen it up with this one if you want to. I think that will be very pretty. And I think that is going to be a look that I really want to create. But overall, yeah, I think it is a very nice palette. I think this will be a companion palette for a lot of people. For me, it will probably be a standalone palette unless I pull in, for instance, a dark purple. I really, really like this one, guys. I love the shade Midnight. This is just that steely bluish gray. I love shades like this. And I think I have, I don't know how many I have of this one, but just this all over the lid and then maybe blend it out a little bit with the black. Oh, gorgeous. Or with the dark gray. Gorgeous, gorgeous. I think it is a very pretty palette. I had a lot of fun creating this look. And yeah. Let me know down below what you think of it. Do I think it's worth its money? Yeah, I have not had a real dud in these. So if you like them, I like them. It's just that sometimes I really need to check how many mattes are in here. In the palette, because that kind of changes. So yeah, this was my smoking look and review. Let me know down below if you like the palette, if you want the palette, if you have the palette. And then let's get ready for the... Feeling spicy and smoking and feeling spicy. Never mind. Makeup will be down in the description box. Let's just, yeah. The Feeling Spicy palette. Yeah. It's, wow. The name is very apt. Is that the word I'm looking for? I don't know. But it is giving me spicy vibes for sure. It's also a 9-pan palette. It has 6 true mattes and then one kind of almost a sequency shade and then 2 shimmers. And this actually swatched the best of all the palettes, all the mini palettes that I have from Makeup Obsession. And yeah, it's very pretty to look at, or at least I think so. It's really drawing me in this time of year, and I specifically am drawn to the shade Cinnamon, which looks, when I look at it in the pan, it looks purple-brown. But when I kind of then finger swatch it, it looks brown. I do want to use it today. And yeah, there is a color difference between the shade Pumpkin and Ginger. And Pumpkin is here in the corner, which is an orange. And then this one is a little bit more reddish orange. Yeah, that's what it looks like to me at least. So yeah, faces are all ready to go. Eyes are primed and all of that. I kind of want to see how many shades I can cram into my eyeballs today. I don't know if I am able to cram them all on my eyeballs. However, I think I'm going to start with the shade Ginger Red. Because I think I'm going to go for basically a neutrally crease. And then an orange heavy bottom. I think something like that today. Okay, let me get some brushes. Because that is also handy, is it not? I'm going to start with the shade called Ginger Red. So, fluffy brush. And I'm just going to tap it on my eye. My base is still a bit tacky, so that's why I'm tapping it on. Yeah, that very, very light shade, I could put it underneath my brow bone later, but usually I don't really use shades like that. I do think this is a very versatile palette, especially if you like these tones. Yes, it is, for a lot of people, a very neutral palette. However, for me, it is a neutral palette, but it is also kind of orange heavy, and orange for me... It's not a neutral, because it's not a brown. So orange is a color, even though a lot of people consider it a neutral. For me, it's a color. So I can see this being a nice, you know, everyday palette for a lot of people, actually. Yeah. So I'm going to go to the shade called Pumpkin first, for underneath my eye now. And I'm actually going lightly. Now this part of my eye is set. I do want to blend it a little bit up. I am going to go to the next shade, which is going to be the shade called Cinnamon. Where are you there? And I'm so curious to see how this one will look on the eye. Especially because it has that purple in it, you know? I'm very curious. When I put it on my eye, it kind of has that purple. It seems like it shines through. Now, my undertone is neutral. So, yeah, it could be that it is different for you if you have a, I don't know, yellow or an olive or a pink undertone. I don't know. It's an interesting shade. And this is really the shade that draw me in a lot when I saw this palette. Okay, back to the first brush and the shade Gingerbread to blend it out. And the shade Gingerbread almost kind of, I don't know, almost looks a little bit more orangey on my eye than it does in the pan. Okay, I do want to build that shade up that I just used, but I'm going to use a different brush for that. So back to the shade called Gingerbread, but now with a fluffier brush. Let's see how well it will layer. Pretty, pretty, pretty. I'm going to go to a smaller brush to build it up in the crease a little bit more before I go and darken it up. Nice. It almost gives me, I don't know, a grungy, orangey, warm-toned look. Back to the first brush. Just to go over everything. Okay. Shall I continue with the bottom? Let's. I want the shade Ginger, this one, in the outer corner of the bottom lash line. I'm fading it a little bit in though. Okay, cleaning the brush. Then I'm going to go to the shade called Ginger, which has that micro sparkle in it, but it's also a little bit more red. Oh, and then the shade Pumpkin. And you know what I do like about the sequence shades is that usually they are very easily picked up with a brush and nice and pigmented. That's what I really like about those shades. For the rest, yeah. It is a pretty color though. Okay, then I'm going to go just with the same brush to the shade called What's Your Flavor, the darkest one. Because I'm going to darken up the outer corner now and I'm going to do that on the lower lash line too. Let's see how dark hair get hair. How dark we can get that. And then I'm drawing a line up a little bit and then flicking it in. And then in the crease I am stretching my eyeball. No, I cannot stretch my eyeball, I'm stretching my eyelid. Wow. Because I kind of want to get a line. Now I'm not too worried about the bottom part of that line, but I kind of want that upper part nice. Okay, then I'm going to go back to that purpley shade, the shade called Cinnamon. I'm going to go over it, but a little bit higher. Just a fraction higher. And let's put it here as well. Oh yeah, that's nice. Okay. I am going to go back to the shade Gingerbread though, the first shade I used. Let's put it here as well. Just blend out the bottom eye area thingamajingy, whatever. I cannot speak, which is not weird for me, just so you know. Let's grab the NYX Glitter Primer and the brush. I'm going to put it on my eye, obviously. I'm going to be a little bit precise. And then I'm going to go to the shade called Hot, which is the lightest shimmer in the palette. That's going to go on my lid. And it's a deceiving palette almost, this one. And then here on the darkest part, I'm just going to go, the brush is basically dry, there's no glitter primer there. Just a little like that, yes. And then I'm going to go back to the... I'm going to go to cinnamon first, at least. With the same brush, I'm going to go into the darkest brown, just for the outer part. Cutesy. For the lower lash line, I think I'm going to... I'm torn between a dark purple and an orange. Only it's not really a purple. It's a tiny bit of purple. But it's the one that shows up. It's from Root Cosmetics. It's a micro one from, what is it? City of Flashing Lights in the shade Bright Lights. And it will be in the description box as well. Okay. Yeah, I think that is fun. Now the rest of the bottom lash line. I'm going to go to the shade called, what's it called? Mood? I think so. The center one. So the orangey shimmer. I'm going to use that on my lower lash line. I'm going to spray it. So first I pick up eyeshadow. And then I'm going to spray the brush. And it's going to go on my lower lash line. Oh yeah, I don't like that. Fine. Okay, I'm cleaning my brush. I'm going to go back into the shade What's Your Flavor, the dark brown. And I'm going to put it on the outer part. Up and bottom. Let's grab my face highlighter, which is the Nomad Studio 54 in the shade Disco Nights. It's going to go in the inner corner. But I didn't. I also kind of wanted a little bit, just a tiny tad, just a little hint of extra. Let me finish everything off and then I will be back and give you my opinion on this palette. Is it spicy or is it bland? Oh, that's a nice... I don't know. Never mind. Everything is on. Here is the completed look. I used my more dramatic falsies because my other ones are downstairs. But I do really like these with this look. It kind of offsets a little bit the darker lip, you know, that I put on. And the lip is from X Revolution. It's one of their, I don't know, their liquid, matte liquid lipsticks in the shade Frank. I want to say Prank, but it's Frank. So yeah. That is what I have on the face and the rest will be listed down below. Now, let's chat about the palette. When I first saw this, I was like, it's a pretty neutral palette, but there were some shades that really drew me in. For instance, the shade Cinnamon that I really, really like. I think this is a very nice palette. The shades performed beautifully. They are a little bit more vibrant on the base side that was still a little bit sticky, which was this side, because by the time that I went to work on this side, it had set well, yeah, that's it, it had set, and the stickiness was minimal, and I had to build this side up just a little bit more than this side, but I could get there no problem. Almost all the shades kind of have a little bit of an oranginess to them. I noticed it when I see the shade Gingerbread here in the pan. It reminds me of actually more of the color of Cinnamon than the color of Cinnamon is, if that makes any sense at all. But when I put it on my eye, it pulled a little bit more orange. And then the shade What's Your Flavor, which is the darkest brown, also has a little bit of an orange. So the only one that kind of doesn't is the shade Cinnamon. It did blend out very beautifully in the other shades though. I don't really know how it blends out in the orange. I think it will be okay, but it could be that it turns a little bit muddy. But maybe not. The reason that I paired it with the purple lip is because I really wanted to bring out the purpleness in that shade. And I also added another eye pencil, by the way. It's an Aubergine one. It will be linked down in the description box. Overall, I think this is a very nice versatile color story. The mattes performed beautifully. The shimmers that are in here are gorgeous. This could have been a shimmer for me, yes. But that's only because I actually don't use this shade often. Overall, I really like this color story a lot. It is more versatile than the smoking one, for me at least. I can use the smoking one on its own, but yeah, for me it is also more, I don't know, more of a companion palette. So it can go on its own. I can combine it with all the other palettes that I have here in my collection. And this I can see being a very nice everyday palette for someone. Just this. You can do brown, you can do orange, you can combine like I did today. I think actually that if you use the shade Cinnamon all over as a one matte, one colored crease, maybe blend it out with the shade Spice, you can make it pull a little bit more purple. But that is the vibe that I get from this palette. I really, really like this one. These palettes are, in my humble opinion, the best ones yet, but that's maybe also because that's the color story that I'm really vibing with right now. So yeah, that is going to be it for this video, guys. I hope you enjoyed both looks. Let me know down below if you want the palettes, if you have gotten the palettes. Let's chat about it down in the comment section. I will link where you can find them down below. And I will also link the makeup that I have on my face. Thank you so, so much for watching. I'm going to go to the site for a special thank you for all my members that you see scrolling on the screen. Now, if you want to become a member, there's a link to join down in the description box. And yeah, before you leave, don't forget to subscribe. If you like the video, give it a thumbs up. If you have any questions or comments, please leave them down in the comment section below. I'm going to wish you a fantastic day, a fabulous evening. May your foundation always match your neck. And I will see you very soon in my next one. Bye, guys.